Mayor, I'm going to call the meeting to order with the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Carter.
Here.
Riley.
Here.
Schneider.
Here.
Sofa.
Here.
Stute.
Here.
Wilson.
Here.
Sufis.
Here.
You're by yourself?
Yeah.
All right, well, wait then, I guess, all right?
Well, because I didn't know that the meeting was changed for last week, so they were here for the first week.
You want, they're not coming then?
Yeah, they're not coming tonight.
Come on up, we'll just announce it. Tammy from the Memphis Chamber?
The Memphis Chamber of Commerce chose Sage Creek Winery as the business of the month for the month of January. The reason we chose Sage Creek Winery is they have new owners, and they reopened the winery. They're making some changes and updates. They're still doing some of the great wine. Jim and Sherry are still involved in it, but they also they're doing parties, tastings, and they also now offer gourmet coffee. I know that they will be coming into another meeting, but I just wanted to just promote them for this month. So we're encouraging anybody to go in. If you haven't been in, please go in and visit them. And if you've already been in, go in and say hello to the new owners. I think they'll be a really good, really great asset to the community. And we're looking forward to being a part of the Chamber of Commerce.
Thank you, Tammy.
Thank you.
City administration, Donna? Chief?
Not much, just happy new year to everybody. We're building our new cars next week, so we should have them in the beginning of February.
Thank you. David?
Okay, we've scheduled a skate day for Saturday, February 3rd, starting at 2 p.m. We're planning on hot dogs, hot cocoa, a movie for the young ones that can't get out on the ice. And I'd like to thank Barton and guys for filling it for me. And hopefully the weather will stay cold. You never know with that. Our senior get-together, the next one is on Valentine's Day, February 14th, from 3 p.m. to whenever. We had a time change. This is so that the seniors can play cards and get home before dark, because a lot of them can't drive in the dark. So we've upped it an hour so they can have time to play cards. Still have an open jam from 6 to 9 on Thursdays. Going well with that. And that's all I got for tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. We have a couple amendments for the agenda.
We need to have an agenda under new business number 3, fire department training, and under new business number 4, appointment of Ken Riley to the fire department or fire authority commission. Do we want to add the school tax?
Sure, but.
You want to discuss that tonight then?
Do you want to?
It's up to you, but your decision.
Yeah, I mean, we might as well.
Okay. New business number 5? Now I'll take a motion.
I'll make a motion to read that for the agenda.
Support.
Riley?
Yes.
Schneider?
Yes.
Sofa?
Yes.
Stutes?
Yes.
Wilson?
Yes.
Sufis?
Yes.
Carter?
Yes.
Okay, hopefully you've all had a chance to look over the meeting minutes from the 3rd of January. Does anybody have any questions or comments?
I'll make a motion to accept the minutes on January 3rd, 2018. Meeting as presented.
Or.
Schneider?
Yes.
Sofa?
Yes.
Stutes?
Yes.
Wilson? Sufis?
Yes.
Carter?
Yes.
Riley?
Yes.
Communications, we don't have any. No unfinished business. bid for Portman Road. Larry?
Yeah, it was bid out on, the bid's coming on January 5th, and I got a call from Phil at our BMJ Engineering on the results. And it did come up, it was higher than the original grant. However, since it was capped, the our percent is still at 20%. So instead of paying 20% at the $84,269.03, there's an additional increase of $10,523. So the total payout then is the combination of both of those, and I didn't have them added up, by the way. I thought I did. Anyway, so what we need is we'll need a motion to approve the additional expense. The project dates as proposed, March 31st, 2018, any trees and et cetera will be removed. Starter construction will be date will be after April the 1st. And the majority of the project will be completed by the August of 12, 2018. There will be a pre-construction meeting prior to the start of pre-construction. And I just put a note on there that we really have over $300,000 in Main Street Fund, and so that'll cover the engineering costs and this cost as well. If there's no further discussion, then I would need a motion. Can I make a motion?
Anybody have any questions?
My only question is the road going to be shut down?
I think from the meeting we had way back, I think there will be some shutdown on the street. Isn't that correct?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. It's so narrow right now. You couldn't work on one side and have traffic going down the other.
Because it's one area, it's really narrow down there. So I think there will be some detours.
Where exactly does it start and stop?
It starts at the city limits on the east, and it comes to Cole Street.
Cole Street. Mm-hmm.
Any further discussion? Okay, then I'll make a motion that you approve the additional expense of $10,523. That will be added to the $84,269. I won't have the total up, so.
Support.
Sofa.
Yes.
Dukes.
Yes.
Wilson.
Yes.
Tsoukas.
Yes.
Marder.
Yes.
Riley.
Yes.
Schneider.
Yes. Thank you, Larry. I know you put a lot of time in that.
Yes, we did.
Just finally running the final curve here, right?
Yeah. Hopefully now we can get kind of thrown in the hopper to continue it. It won't be immediately, but we're looking into that right now.
Okay, advisory committee personnel policy.
You go ahead, Larry.
Okay. This has been reviewed now for, I guess, over a year, and there's really only, most of the changes are just minor, basically in language, and also to incorporate actually how the policy's been enforced. And so the only one issue that we have a little difference of opinion on is on the payout of the sick pay. And I guess maybe I just should go over briefly. I'm sure you've read the minutes here of the meeting, but originally, back in August 5th, 1996, when this was drafted and approved, it stated that full-time regular employees shall be entitled to accrue sick days to a maximum of 100 days. And then the next sentence is, accumulated sick leave pay shall not be paid to an employee upon termination of employment. So this was changed by the advisory committee in 6104 because it actually, the way that was worded, if they had any accumulated sick pay, they would lose it. So it was changed then to full-time regular employees shall be entitled to accrue sick days to a maximum of 2,000 hours. Employees will be to be paid 50% of accumulated sick days after 21 years of service. And changing this and discussions with the labor relations lawyer and so on, He indicated that it was very unusual to pay accumulated sick time prior to the end of employment. And he asked what the intent was. And I was on council at the time, though not on an advisory committee. And I think that the intent really was so that employee, when he ended his employment, would not lose the accumulated sick time if he had any. And when Liz retired after 30 years, she took that at the end of the employment. So what were, since we didn't come to a consensus, I was in the minority on this issue, and if it's voted on, I may be 7-1, I don't know, but whatever it is. So we made two options, and the options on one is that we have it stated as follows: full-time employees shall be entitled to accrue sick days to a maximum of 2,000 hours. After 21 years of service, employee will pay 50% of the accrued and unused sick days accumulated by said employee at the end of employee. What that option does then, it makes it back and reverse, or puts it back to what the intent was. Now, the option two, and this was some of the employees wanted, and some of the on the advisory committee wanted as well, is to grandfather in the current employees. So that way we would state the first paragraph as I already stated above, but then we would put full-time employees hired after July 1st, 2017 shall be entitled to accrue sick time to a maximum of 2,000 hours, and after 20 years of service shall be paid 50% of its value of any accrued sick days accumulated by said employee at the end of employment. So what we're doing then is full-time employees current full-time employees would then be grandfathered in, and it would still be after 21 years service if they elected to take it at that time. So those are the two options, but then there's another option here that where we would actually leave it as is, and everyone would be just grant, or it would be after 21 years of service. So those are the three options. The last option I would be really against. I think we should try to correct it to what its intent was. So I don't know if there's any discussions, we can discuss it, and I think then we'll have to have a motion to see what we want to do. So I think.
Was there a consensus with the committee as to what they recommended?
Not really. I was in the minority. I think we should actually put it back the way it was, but
The way it was meant to be.
However, if the consensus of council is to grandfather current employees in, then I'm not going to stamp my feet on the lawn. The only one I don't really like is the
option number three.
I guess it's open for discussion, and then we can vote on which one we want to go.
Kurt, what's your thoughts?
Well, I definitely think that we have to, or we should have our current employees grandfathered in. But I, you know, look at option number three and leaving it the way it is, where it's kind of a somewhat of an incentive for any new employees that we may get to be setting up a situation where they may not want to use their sick days, and it's kind of a offhand annuity savings, whatever you want to call it, so that they would be able to have an incentive to stick around for 21 years, as opposed to, you know, okay, you know, after 21 years they'd be able to collect it, as opposed to having to wait to the end of their employment. So, you know, number two, number three, you know, the way the council wants to go, I'm open to both. I would, myself, I'd like to see option number three left on the table because of the simple fact that, like I say, let's throw an incentive out there for anybody that would want to come to work here in the future.
Scott, what's your thoughts?
Mine was really the options on all of them is just the fact of the matter was that we don't know that anyone's going to stay on the job for 21 years anymore.
Right.
I mean, we're not that big of a town. We don't have that much to offer. It's just, it is what it is. It's just a, it's a little bit of bonus, but it's not that much. I mean, any one of them, it could get blown out the door just by them leaving after 10 years because they get a better job, better offer. 20 years is an awful long time.
What happens if they leave after 10 years? Do they get what they...
No, they...
No. No, the reason it was put in is because, originally it was put in, is because the way it was originally written, they would get nothing. And so that's why it was put in by the advisory committee and okayed by council so that they wouldn't lose that. But I was on council, and I don't think the intent at that time, I had a lot of conversation with Todd Shoddy on this too, and that was why we, I would favor number one, however, I would accept number two, and number three I don't like at all. So it's just my opinion, but I'm only one person on council, so it's up to the council as a whole. So.
Any other discussion?
Why do they have a year limit on it? Why can't you collect it at the end of every year if you don't use it?
Well, you accumulate it because you don't know what your you don't know what the future holds.
Right.
And so someone could be I was going to say older, but I could say any employee
right.
is subject to something to happen. So if you have it accumulated, then you can use it. So it's for the benefit of the employee in case they have a long-term illness of some sort that they won't lose income.
Normally, governmental employees aren't.
They roll it. They accumulate it.
Yeah, but they don't get paid for it.
No.
Yeah.
Well, they can retire. Can't they retire like 3 months and then use it then?
Yeah, when you retire, you can get a percentage of it. But like a lot of places, you may work through the year. At the end of the year, you have 10 sick days left over, and they would pay you
that's
you for
how
it.
Ours does.
Right, that's how most manufacturing plants that I've been involved with, at the end of the year, they basically just cash you out.
You could cash in your hours anytime.
Well, this is the policy that's in place right now, and so it's just correcting what. It's trying to make it.
It was sort of an incomplete sentence more than anything, right?
Pardon?
It was kind of an incomplete sentence.
It was really. It was, and unfortunately, we.
But that's how it's written.
Yeah, we just didn't catch it. And matter of fact, no one really even expected. Liz caught it at the end, and no one really even caught it till somebody actually looked at it and said, "Well, yeah, we can pay it." I actually called our lawyer. To ask then, could we? And he said, well, you normally don't do it, but he said, since that's where it's actually written, if somebody wanted to claim it, they could, which we had an employee that did, by the way.
Didn't we just have Bart do that?
Yes.
Yes.
Because that's what it said.
And under the new number one, he wouldn't have been able to do that.
No, he'd get it at the end of the employment. Yeah.
Okay.
And of course, there's no one that this currently really has a lot of accumulated sick time anyway. And main reason Bart gets that much sick time is that he has so much comp time that if he's sick, he takes his comp time. So the sick time, theoretically, is not used, so that accumulates. And the maximum, of course, right now is 2,000 hours. So if he collected what she did for whatever it was, then he's only got the balance that he can use. It don't start from zero and go back up to... And again, another 2,000 hours. The maximum one employee can accumulate is 2,000. The maximum that can be paid out is 50% of whatever that is.
Okay. Now, you got option number two is basically just to phase out one way of doing it and phase in the other.
That's exactly what it does. It grandfathers the current employees in where they'd still be under that if they had worked here 29 years. Then, if they elected to take it, they could. Whether it was accumulated or whatever portion of that they wanted to. But then if any employee hired after that, then would be under what the intent originally was of that. That's what it is. So is is there any more discussion on it at this point then?
Does options all include the changes that were made to all the different articles? All three include that, you know, you're talking the change in this article, delete this one?
No, everything's been changed in both policies. And like I said, most of them are just minor changes, making corrections so that they're how we actually use it or their language and that kind of thing. And the only, like I said, the only issue we have is this issue, and that's what we want to change. That's what we want council to vote on, which way we want to go.
I think anyone puts up any place for 21 years deserves something, so I'll go with three. You're not gonna swap me up to the head or nothing, are you?
No.
What's the difference between one and three?
Really not a lot of difference, I guess, because it's just you're just leaving it as is, and you're right, it's not a lot of difference.
Which just cleans up the language a little bit.
But I say if
option number one, it would take everything off the table. Number two leaves it on the table for current employees.
Right.
Number three leaves it on the table for future employees and current employees.
The only thing that really changes is that after 21 years, they have the option to take that money then. If not, they have to wait till they quit, retire, or fire after 21 years. Then they could do it.
Options
out of the employee.
Right. Option number one would eliminate current employees. Option number two keeps the current employees covered under said language. Mm-hmm. Number three would cover current and future employees.
Yeah, that's the difference.
So number three, the only difference between two and three is number three would be a tiny incentive for our future employees to come in and hang around for 21 years.
There's definitely value in that too. So,
you know, like I say, we don't offer a pension,
easy decision, that's for sure.
Yeah, like I say, we don't offer a pension, we don't offer annuities, a 401k, or anything like that. And the cost to the city, you know, when you look at it in the case where, when somebody took the money, basically it was about $1,000 a year, right?
I think it was a little more than that. But
it may be $1,100, $1,200 a year.
It was substantial.
Well, yeah, when you look at over 23 years, then it becomes more money. And that's why I say that's where you turn around and you're giving them the chance to, set up some sort of a savings for themselves through showing up for work and not using their sick days.
Right. Getting fired, not quitting.
Right. And I mean, that's the big thing. You're not using your sick days. So you're here. Yeah. You're not just using the sick day because,
a lot of the corporations are leaning towards sick days, vacation days. At the end of the year, if you don't use them, you lose them.
You don't get paid for them.
No.
Use them and
lose them. Okay, so would anyone want to make a motion then on one of these? Or I can make a motion on one, and if I don't get support, it stops. Somebody make a motion?
Well, let's just take a straw poll then. So, one, two, or three?
Three. One.
Three?
Two.
Two. Two. I like the phase out. I do like the inside of poll.
Well, it looks like we made a motion for number two, it would pass.
Okay, then. I'll make a motion, you can word this
One thing to think about, 10 years from now, this could be changed again. So it's not like this is written in stone or anything.
I'll make a motion that we approve the two.
So full-time employees will be entitled to accrue sick days to a maximum of 2,000 hours after 21 years.
Why wouldn't they want to be grandfathered in? Wouldn't you want them to be grandfathered?
I don't, I really, personally, I don't. I'd rather number one, but I'm just trying to get this moved.
I mean, if they, all these years, they thought that that's how it would be.
Which is something that from
the... They really didn't.
From a...
No one really...
Larry's looking at it from the city's financial point of view.
Fiscal, yeah.
I'm looking at it more from a personal point of view.
So high.
Personnel.
As a personnel point, yeah. As an employee, so...
Well, then, all right, then, somebody, if, let, somebody will make a, somebody make a motion then. Get this resolved.
Well, you'd already made a motion for option number two, right?
Yeah, but I don't really want it.
You don't have to vote for it.
Support for option two.
Stoops.
Yes.
Wilson.
No.
Dukas.
Yes.
Murder.
Yes.
Riley.
Yes.
Schneider.
Yes.
Sofa.
Yes.
Well, I said it'd be 1 second.
Permit that, that'd be gonna start spitting some glass out of your mouth. Thank you, Larry. I know you put a lot of time into this also. I mean, this has been going on for over a year now, right?
Yeah, I rewrote the whole thing.
And I keep raising his gander.
I put this thing together and did it off to the lawyer for the final,
Thanks, Larry.
So we got a bill here for some fire training. To the St. Clair County Association of Fire Chiefs for $1,300. We want to make a motion.
I'd like to make the motion that we approve $1,300 for two fire academy tuitions.
Support.
Wilson.
Yes.
Dukas.
Yes.
Murder.
Yes.
Riley.
Yes.
Schneider.
Yes.
Sofa.
Yes.
Stoops.
Yes.
Okay, we need a motion to appoint Tim Riley to the Fire Authority Board.
I'll make that motion. I'll support it.
Dukas.
Yes.
Murder.
Yes.
Riley.
Yes.
Schneider.
Yes.
Sofa.
Yes.
Stoops.
Yes.
Wilson.
Yes. And the changing the collection of the school's taxes. Jason?
Well, the school approached us with this proposal, what they want, as it is now, what they do is they borrow from the state, what was it, 1.6?
1.6
million. 1.6
million
they borrow from the state, and they pay back in interest $18,000. So basically, they're out money, and what that money, what they use it for is to cover their payroll. Just the way that their year works and everything, it covers their payroll. As far as I hear, all the surrounding districts are going forward with it, or not districts, but the townships that are in our district are going forward with it in their end. The impact for them will be what they never had is summer tax before, right?
That's right.
And now they're creating a new summer tax for people in the township. They're going to have two tax bills like we do now. So I think it's going to be a tough transition. I think some people are going to be a little unhappy about it, but the way it was stated, it's inevitable. It's going to happen. You're paying it anyway, whether you pay it to the county or the state or through us. The bad part about it is there's the first year that's a transition year, and Larry provided us with some numbers here and also a way to defer it. Now, I'm under the assumption if they want to, they could defer it every year.
Yes.
The form could be reused every year if you wanted it just a separate form, and you can keep paying it just like you've been.
Well, you got to be a 62 or over to have it different.
Yeah, there's certain criteria.
Certain criteria for it, right? Yeah. Was it just 62 or was there was income too? $40,000 or less.
Right.
We're talking about the people who are hardest hit by this difference, you know, you will be offered a way to defer it. But once that first year is over, it's not like we're paying any more. It's just that we're paying it at a different time.
You're paying the same amount.
Six months early.
But the school's actually getting more money because they're not paying any interest, and they don't need to borrow the money to handle their operating costs until it's collected in the.
And if you look at the spreadsheet, do you mind, Jason?
Go ahead.
If you look at the spreadsheet I made out, there's three taxes. Two are school debts, and one's a sinking fund. But the millage is 6.25. And then I just took at random four examples of home value. And there were 75,000, 100,000, 150,000, and 200,000. And of course, the taxable value theoretically is 50% of that. So at the lowest, you'd be paying $234 per year. And the 100,000 home, you'd be paying $312.50. 150,000 with a 75,000 taxable value is $468.75. Then a 200,000. 100,000 taxable value, 625. So just give you an example of kind of what the spread would be.
So basically, that's, you know, that would be shifted from your winter tax bill to your summer tax bill.
And what it'll do, it'll decrease, if you take your total taxes what you pay, it will decrease what you pay in the winter bill by 15%, but it'll increase your what you pay in the summer by 15%. So so you'll pay less in the winter, and then you'll pay more in the summer.
So basically, the first year of the change is when everybody's going to see the big hit.
That's what we're most worried about, or that's the biggest concern, or most concerned about everyone who is on the finance committee, is that first year. The people who, you know, we may only be talking about $400, but it's a matter of perspective. $400 is a lot for some people on fixed incomes. And,
sure.
You know, people who are going, you know, like Robbie said, paycheck to paycheck, all of a sudden you've got more to pay this year and you didn't budget it in. They can defer it.
If
they meet the criteria, they could defer it. If not,
depending on age and income level.
Right. Yeah. I mean, the thing is if you're above, lower than that age and higher than that income level, and you've got a high price, your taxable value is kind of high.
So it'd be a one tax bill hit, though.
Yeah.
It's not, you know, so it'll be deferred from winter to summer.
Okay. So if you have a mortgage, it really shouldn't affect you, right? Because
if you have an escrow.
Yeah.
If your taxes are paid out of your mortgage, I don't think it'll be.
Yeah, it does affect it. It depends when your year ends. Mine ends in November, so we will not. My winter money will not be in there again. So it does affect it. Just because if it's in escrow, doesn't mean it's there's
right. It's not always just there.
No.
Yeah.
But if you can get the word out, like now I'll prepare myself for it. So if you got to get the word out and get everybody to understand
that,
it.
That was the proposal. What I wrote up here was. Suggested that, you know, we have an information campaign and let the residents know, here's a breakdown, here's what it's going to do, and explain to them, we're not raising their taxes, it's just
a shift.
During the shift, they're going to pay more at one time. And then after that, it'll be something that, you know, you can call your mortgage company and
if you're set up with an escrow, it really shouldn't affect you.
Not in the long run.
Because
the short run it might be wrong.
Yeah, in the short run.
The first year. Yeah.
The first year. The first year, yeah.
Could be adjustment the first year, but in the long run it will affect. Because you're not paying any more taxes. Just
we need to make a motion to.
Yeah, we have to make a motion.
And just before you vote, they also said.
They made a resolution.
We need to do it today.
Was it just that we clocked it, right?
Yeah. It just
they also said that if we did not pass it, that they could go to the state and have the county collect it.
I talked to the county clerk. She said they don't collect taxes for anybody that does.
That's what he told us.
She said they would have to collect it themselves.
That's
what he told us.
I mean, we collect the taxes already.
I collect it anyway.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Yeah, see, what the reason that the townships, they'll pay them to collect it, from what I gather, the townships, all their taxes are paid in the winter. They have no summer tax. So
well, it depends on the town. The local townships here don't, but further out they do. You know, where my mother's property is, it was probably 3-4 years ago where they went to charging two tax bills.
Yeah, well, that's what they'll be doing now. And so in order to collect that, they will, the city, the school system will pay them to do that. He cited figures, I don't know, a couple dollars?
He had some figures, yeah, there was, I think, $1.50 to $2.50. And basically, because they're creating a new tax day, you know, for property taxes in some of these, in these townships. So they have to do the mailings and do, you know, everything that we do when we put out our tax bills. They have to, you know, do that. So they're asking for compensation for that extra work that they weren't doing before.
But we do it anyway, so we don't have to do that, because it's just a matter of transferring from one to the other.
You're just putting an extra line item on the bill.
Yeah.
So, why? By deferring this, you know, we, with our taxpayers, they get a big hit on, basically on one tax bill and a shift, but it would save the schools approximately $18,000 in interest.
Right.
So by saving the schools some money, you know, we're putting a little hurt on people, but at the same time, if we're saving the schools that much money, that's something that can go right back into the school, and we're not putting further burden on the schools for further taxes. So I, you know, it's one of those, yeah, let's get an information campaign out there to inform our taxpayers that, yeah, you're going to have a bigger hit this summer. But
could be on the water bill.
If anybody reads about this, it's on the water bill.
Maybe we should have a meeting.
You want to table this for another meeting?
No, no. How I'm saying that just to get the word out, maybe we'll try to, you know.
Find the best way to get
paper
out.
Yeah.
Or
a story in the paper.
I think in the voice would be kind of the place to be.
Maybe we can have a meeting somewhere, like at the school,
yeah,
or
we wouldn't make any decisions yet. So this gets out there.
And Brad, I mean, he didn't say it had to be done right now, and it's a make it or break it thing. It would just, even if we said no to it right now, we could do it next year. But like Larry said, might as well do it and move forward and get it, kind of bite the bullet.
Taxes getting cut, collected no matter what.
Yeah.
It's going to happen
so
either way.
No doubt about that.
So let's just do it. If the city's going to help them out, we have no say is that it's moving to July, so all we're doing is saying, can we collect it for them or no?
I mean, really, if you look at it this way, it's like getting an extra $18,000 in your school every year because you're not paying interest on money you have to borrow. So, I mean,
right,
that's the positive side of it.
But like Ken said, it's happening anyway. It just depends on who's collecting it. We're not changing these numbers. We're not making these dollars up and putting this on our taxpayers, but
we'll just put it on the agenda for the next meeting, then we'll do it then, I guess, right?
I put a couple meetings away until you get a few more people that have a bit more knowledge about what's going on.
Okay.
I'm just saying, you want to get this out in the community first and see what backlash is coming before we start making that decision on it. And well, the school as well.
It's going to happen one way or another.
Not necessarily.
We asked for a 1 year wait to get some.
If there's enough backlash up at the school about it, it could be rescinded.
Well, no, they've had their elections already done, and the townships are already going to be in there.
I think they've already passed a resolution on it, the school board.
Yeah.
Everything.
I understand that, Larry, but we could all leave these jobs pretty quickly either after the end of our terms, much like the school board can. These things can change. That's the whole point of our government body. If this has not been spread around all that much in the community, and can't say that I've heard anything from anybody.
No, this is from the last.
It was in the paper, though. That's where I saw it back in December.
I got a couple phone calls about it, but that was like 2 or 3 days before the meeting, and the meeting was on a Monday, and I couldn't go, so.
I got a phone call about it, too.
Yeah, I know you did.
You got the same one?
He couldn't get a hold of me. Somebody called you, and then called me back.
Okay.
The same table for a couple meetings.
Sure. Absolutely. I mean, it really is not going to be table because we...
Well, yeah, Brad had some more stuff that... I can't remember what it was, but he had some more figures for us too that might help out with.
Well, he'll come to the next, because I think they want a decision on this rather quickly. He'll come to the next meeting when we're going to, if we're going to discuss it. But you'd have to call him or.
Yeah, I'll call him.
If we're not on the agenda for the next council.
Is he the next regular council meeting?
Yeah.
Sounds good. All right, thank you. From the mayor. Well, the Women's Life Chapter 855 group is having a chili cook-off at the elementary school Saturday, January 27th from 5 to 7. It's $5 or $10 for a family. They'll have chili, hot dogs, pop, water, and there's going to be some secret judges. Sounds like it's going to be a pretty good time, and they're going to raise money for their the Memphis Schools Backpack Program, which apparently was not what I thought it was. It is actually, they put together backpacks of food for disadvantaged families that they actually take home with them for the weekend. So it's actually a pretty cool program, I think. So anybody's interested in that, you can get more information. They have a Facebook page. It's actually Girlfriends 855 on Facebook. That's their Women's Life Chapter Facebook page. And this will be up here in the city office if anybody wants to look at it.
I'll be one of the secret judges.
That's
never
a
secret.
Secret.
They didn't tell me it was a secret.
Oh.
I never worked undercover, right?
I hope I can handle this.
All right. That's all I have. Kurt?
Nothing for me.
Larry?
Nothing for me.
Ken?
Nothing.
Robbie? Yeah?
Nothing.
Jason?
Nothing for me.
I just want to say this was a great meeting tonight. I know a lot of work went into what we talked about tonight, and I'm really proud of you guys. Good job.
Motion to adjourn.
Thank you.